Class. Today in our class, I am going to discuss with you climate of Asia. As you know, Asia is the largest continent on the earth. As it is the largest continent on the earth, we also experience here different type and variety of climates here. These varied climates include the bitter cold of the polar north. As we will go north area, we experienced very cold weather, minus 32 degree in winter time, and in the center and the west part we experience hot dry desert. And we will go, as we will come down southwest, we experience hot humid and tropical weather. As in India, we will experience monsoon weather and some side hot humid weather. The temperature also varies from 100 degree in some parts of Asia to below freezing in the other parts. Like in Middle East and in the desert, it will go up to 54 degree in the summer season. And in winter season, in north parts, in January, temperature is always minus degree. And sometime it will go below minus 32 degree. So now, let's discuss distribution of rainfall. Again, I am going to say Asia is a very big continent. Due to distribution of rainfall is also uneven. Somewhere we will get rainfall, somewhere we will get more than 300, somewhere 200, and somewhere less than 100, like that. Like in India, in Northeast Asia, like Northeast Asia, this is here, this is a state in India, this is Meghalaya. In Meghalaya, there is one area named Chirapunji. It's a very famous place. Here we will get in monsoon area more than 1000 centimeter in a year. In the monsoon area, we will experience more than 1000 centimeter rainfall, which is too much. It is more than 300. It's extreme. And this is the most rainfall area in the whole world. Sometime question come, in which area of the world we will get the more rainfall? You can write Chirapunji in Meghalaya. How much we will experience? More than 1000 centimeter rainfall we will experience in monsoon season. Not in every season, in monsoon season we will experience more than 1000 centimeter of rainfall. Now see this chart and also this map. Look here. This is the most dark green part. Dark green, little bit lighter, again light, then little bit blue, then light brown and dark brown. This is above 300 centimeter. It is between 200 to 300 and 100 to 200. Go like this. Okay, now see. This dark green part, the large, this one, this is mostly coast. And this is the northeast and this is southeast. All. Okay, here we will experience, we will get more than 300 centimeter rainfall. In the monsoon area, especially. Monsoon season, sorry. Okay, now light green, this is India's north part also, like this is Punjab and this one, West Bengal, this side, okay, all this one. Here this is coastal side, Kerala, Maharashtra, okay, Tamil Nadu. Here we will get near about, more above than 200 centimeter, in between 200 to 300 centimeter. When we experience more rainfall, when we will get the rainfall more? In monsoon area, like now, this time, in from 15th June to August, sometime due to global warming, we will get up to September also rainfall. These days, anytime we will get rainfall due to the global warming. Okay, now this one, 100 to 200 centimeter. Okay, in some area, it's very light green. Where we will get it is, but mostly it is 200 centimeter. These are all coastal areas. Okay, so now look at polar area. Very less, even the no rainfall at all. We will experience here snowfall, but no rainfall. In desert, this one Middle East, this is Central, okay. Here we don't experience, we don't get any rainfall, very less. Maybe sometime, maybe in between 0, 25 to 50, but hardly sometime we will get rainfall in these areas, okay. Now, let's discuss factors affecting climate of Asia. The geography of a region influences its climate. Our physical features. There are five major geographical factors that have been identified to affect the climate of an area. Now let's discuss. First is latitude. You know the definition of latitude. Lines which will go from west to east is called latitude, horizontally. Okay. latitude or the distance from the equator is the most apparent, means evident, geographic indicator of climate. Means as if we were close to the equator, our latitudes, if we were close to the latitude, we will experience hot weather. Okay, the area closer to the equator experience hot climate, as you know, because on the equator sun rays reach directly. Hence, the hottest climates are closest to the equator, with climate tending to become increasingly cooler with an increase in distance from the equator. As we will go far from the equator, we will experience cool climate, and as we will go far, then we will experience very cold weather, as on the North Pole. Now, on Earth, we have three heat zones. Look here at the diagram. Okay? This diagram is given by Aristotle, and he divided the earth zone into three zones. One is temperate zone, torrid zone, and frigid zone. Temperate zone, when we have a moderate temperature, moderate rainfall, everything in a moderate. Torrid zone, when we have very, very hot weather, same in the desert or in Middle East. Frigid zone, like from the fridge, you can see frigid zone, when we have very, very cold climate, that is called frigid zone. Okay, on the this one. Like this light blue, this is our frigid zone. Green, as you know, green is the prosperity. Same here, moderate. Red zone, very hot. When we, you know, when temperature is very high, sometime our face also get red. So due to that, the red color describes the torrid zone. Light blue is frigid zone, and green, moderate zone. Okay. So, as mentioned earlier, the Asian continent is an extremely large landmass. There are 90 parallels of latitude running across 0 degree to here, 10 degree south, and up to 80 degree north. The climate ranges from extremely cold and dry climates in the northern region to very hot and wet climates in the north. The parts of Asia which fall in the temperate zone have a temperature type of temperate type of moderate type of climate, which is characterized by moderate climate, that is neither very hot nor very cold. In the coastal area where we have sea, there we experience a very moderate climate. If day is hot, evening time we will get some rain, and evening is a night is very very cool, pleasant weather. Like in our Punjab, we experience here very hot and very cold weather. Same in the desert and also in the Middle East area. But in the desert and in the west part of our Asia continent, we experience hot weather. Only sometime in the desert, night time is a very little bit cool weather. Even in the west part of Asia also. But mostly we experience in the central part of Asia and in the west part of Asia, mostly we experience hot weather. Now, distance, number two is distance from the sea. As you know, if we were close to the sea, because sea is full of water, and if we will stay near the water, we will experience cool weather or cold, not cold, cool weather. The vast longitudinal extent of the Asia continent means that many parts of Asia are at a distance from the seas. Therefore, these regions lack the moderating effect of the sea. Some reasons, like we Punjab area, Delhi, we are far from the sea. And if you will see in the Punjab, is there any sea? No sea. Okay. So due to that, we will experience hot weather in the summer and very cold weather in the winter time. Delhi, Punjab, even then in Kashmir, sometime in winter time we have minus 10 degree, minus 12 degree temperature night time in winter. And in summer, 45, sometime it's reached up to 50 degree. In the Rajasthan, we have Thar desert there. Okay. And the regions, those who are very close to the sea, like Bombay, Maharashtra, Kerala, okay, Arabian Sea, you can say that, Bay of Bengal, Tamil Nadu, down Indian Ocean. These areas we experience moderate type of climate. Okay. This results in the extreme temperature in the interior areas of the continent. The interior regions of the continent also do not receive enough rainfall. Places near the sea experience marine climate due to the moderating influence of the sea. As I told you, which area is near close to the sea, there we will experience moderate climate. Means if day is hot, evening time sometime we will, most of the time we will get rain. Due to rain, climate or weather will get cool down. So we experience cool, pleasant weather. But in the areas, those who are far away from the sea, there we have to experience in summer very hot and in winter we have very cold weather. So it is for today's lesson. So tomorrow we will discuss other elements. Thank you.